to provide the industry with best management practices, you have to have a functioning facility that can support that.
We put our hat in the ring in, I think, about 2017, and then we were approved. That was originally for $5 million, and that was to build a new building, which is actually going to be situated, you know, right behind us.
Most of the money came from the environmental bond bill that we passed in the legislature, but some of the money came from UMass itself. So it was really a partnership. Also, there was some private investment.
What it's going to enable us to do is to actually have 5 new labs and additional office space and a new meeting room for our growers. And we predict that it will probably be a 12 to 16 month operation. So if you come back here in the summer of 2022, there should be a brand spanking new building there.
Even though the research station is in Wareham, you know, a long way from Amherst, but that's where the cranberries are. But UMass School of Agriculture has the expertise, has the professionals, has the scientists that know agricultural industries, that know what's necessary in order to make Massachusetts cranberry growers more efficient, more profitable, and keep them in business.
This year, you know, as happens with some years, we had a new bug. So, you know, part of what would happen is a grower says, hey, I've got a lot of dead area out on the bog. We go out there. So our entomologist went out there to see what was going on. There were, you know, patches like as big as a truck or two trucks were dying back. And it turns out there was this little case bearer insect that was actually causing the damage.
The state bog's able to do different testings that we as growers can't do or can't afford. So it's easy to be able to come to the state bog with new insects or they're able to help us get pesticides passed that we could be using or even test genetically the different varieties that they've got planted here that are getting planted in some of the newer bogs that we have.
My best day on the job is, you know, when a grower calls and said, hey, you know that herbicide that you recommended, it worked great, and my crop is better because of it, and I made more money this year.
The station is key to a viable, effective industry. So many of the tools and practices that the industry employs came out of research projects at the station.
I cannot express enough how much I value and appreciate the help, the support, and the partnership from UMass. And the industry will certainly echo those words.